just start putting something down to kind of chronicle how you feel, because ultimately that was with me. I had a tough time expressing myself emotionally, and I just couldn't, because I was taught to be Batman. I was taught to be stoic. I was taught to show no pain, because in my neighborhood, if you showed any kind of weakness, people were going to come after you. Mm. So this, you know, you can't be a man without being human, right? Got to be HU. You got to add that on the front. And if you can't be a human being and have a full spectrum of emotions, then that's not being true and authentic to yourself. So one, you have to be authentic. So a lot of pain is just internalizing things that are saying it's not acceptable to be you. It's always acceptable to be you. That's the key piece. And the other thing is, when you share how you feel, whether it's written, and write a song about it. If you can't do that, I know some people that wrote raps, who wrote poetry, who look, create art, depict it, take what's in here, put it out there. And if it means taking photos of things and putting a collage together, whatever it is, take that, because that's useful. That fire is useful. It's just burning you up on the inside. You got to get it put to the outside. That's the biggest thing. It's like, wow, you know, what I use my pain when I play ball. Oh, I just imagine that whoever's on the other side has something to do with it, right?
Yeah,
and
yeah.
Then the other thing is, because there's a freedom to that. There's a liberation. I think a lot of times we inflict more pain on ourselves than the people on the outside are inflicting on us. So that communication, people, and it's cool to communicate. I had that boy who was crying in my class. Well, his buddy was crying too. I didn't tell you about that. I had two of them crying. The first one was crying because he said he wasn't good at math. The second one, when I took him out in the hall, I said, why are you crying? He said, because he was crying. So he's crying because the other guy's crying. Well, he wanted to cry, but he needed permission to cry. And that's the part where I said, I am thankful for your tears. Now I know where to start. Me, I didn't really like crying in public. Even at a funeral, I'm walking up to my grandmother's coffin, and this is my grandmother, and I'm not crying until I saw my Uncle Rico cry, who's the manliest man I know. And when I saw him cry, I fell out. And I realized that a lot of boys, a lot of people don't feel like they have permission to be a human being. They have to be Batman or some superhero. You don't. And if somebody in your immediate vicinity doesn't accept that and doesn't, there's always, you got to have a team. So adults out there, parents out there, the biggest thing you can do is have a connected team of informed adults who your child trusts. Because they may not talk to you, but as long as they're talking to somebody, we're moving forward.